Now, I'd go to one story before Yama and Yami before I move on. So, these people, when I was telling you that these people were very balanced, one thing I'd like to add is that Yama was born with with a twin called Yami. So they had shared the womb of their mother, Sanjana, for 9 strong months. Now, they are not mere mortals. They are the deities. They are celestial beings. They remember that. So Yami starts developing a huge amount of fascination for Yama and says that let us live together as a couple. Yama is, as I told you earlier, he's had a very wild, we've seen, he went ahead and kicked Sanjana. Okay, so he'd had a very wild childhood, but as he grows up, he becomes more and more protocolish. He becomes very, very staid. He becomes very balanced. And he says that this is not, what you're saying is against the grain. So she says that, we've done Rohini Nakshatra with on this channel. We have done Adra Nakshatra on this channel. So I think I've done Adra Nakshatra with you, Bharati.
I don't remember. I think so. We have done.
Okay, so if you've not done, then when Rahu moves into Adra, we'll do it then. Because Rahu is the lord of Adra, and planet who has lordship over Adra. So then when we're talking about so like when we've done Rohini, so we know that Lord Brahma gave chase to his own creation, Usha. And so she says that earlier on it has already happened. Lord Brahma gave chase to Usha. So he says what happened earlier was something that happened earlier, not in our times, not in your and my time. And I am not going to enforce those views. So it is time that you do not consider me like that. And then he decides to move into the world of ancestors. He decides that he's going to die and then take care of the world of the ancestors. He was initially the first being to move into the world of ancestors, become the ruler of the ancestors. And Yami, having lost a partner in life, somebody whom she's loved all her life, okay, right from her mother's womb, she starts crying and she takes the form of a river, Yamuna. Okay, so so there's a sense of incest, as I say here, okay, because Yama considers that relationship to be instantaneous. So we're talking about Daisy Fellows. She's an American society figure, beauty, minor novelist, poet, Paris editor of American Harper Bazaar. So Harper Bazaar is a very, very famous magazine, and she's a fashion icon. And I remember my Now, I do not know how many people use the sewing machine, but I remember one generation ahead of us, even people in my generation, sewing machine is something that people learn, used to learn. So Singer was a very, very famous sewing machine in those days, and she was an heir to that. And okay, so when I come back to the lady here under talk was that she had gone and seduced so many people. Among them, one of the persons she wanted to seduce was Winston Churchill. And right before she's going to marriage into marriage with his cousin. Okay, and it is said that her mother committed suicide and said that she had an instant incestuous relationship herself. So you see, the 10th lord, again, it's in the sixth house. Sixth house is also the house of incest. And an exalted son is sitting there.
There's another indication here.
Rahu in the 8th house.
Yeah, that could be. I was seeing this Jupiter in the third house.
Okay.
Because third house, they say, is Maithuna Bhava, and Jupiter represents
Yeah.
people who are close to you.
Okay. So,
and in fact, when you were saying of this in the previous slide, I was recalling somebody who has prominent planets in Bharani, and it is related to the 10th house.
Yeah.
He's a man. So then he was telling me, it was like a movie when he was telling me, you know, he was in the office one day and there was one lady who, you know, anyways, we'll talk about
that. Yeah, so these people are very much, these people also become subject, you know, if the planet of that person must be afflicted by malefics. So these people become subjects to incest. Instead of the ones to do that kind of a thing, they become susceptible to be drawn to that kind of a...
Yes, they become victims actually.
They become victims.
And if the Lagna Lord is involved, then they themselves can be like that, like we saw in Hitler's case.
Yeah, they can do that. They can, if the Lagna Lord, as you said, is involved, then they can be the ones inflicting that kind of a behavior.
And then later on, this person, he told me what happened was, it's very similar to this, you know, that cursing thing. And then later on, he told me when he denied this lady, then this lady was the wife of his boss. And then this lady told him that if you don't enjoy with me, then I will throw you out of the office and I will blacklist you in your entire country. You will not find a job. I'm so powerful. And then he told his wife, and then his wife told him, no, better leave the place. Whatever she does, we will see it later.
You remember the movie, it's typically so much like a movie that we have seen, you know, one of the movies, I don't know whether you, I don't remember the name, but yeah, and it's, so these people, so his planet there must be afflicted by malefics, could be afflicted by Venus. Could be afflicted by a malefic, you know?
Yeah, as far as I know, his moon is in Bharani. That's what I know.
So moon is in Bharani and it must be from, so it's a female planet sitting there and it must be from the, showing some problems from the 8th house or something like that. Some affliction from the 8th house or something like that.
Yes, definitely something is there. And can you just go to one, two slides before this? Yeah, that slide. No, this diagram is there, no? Not this.
Yeah,
this one. So this, like these two things which are there, what does this signify?
Yeah, so this is Yama and Yami, you know. So that is, they are, Yamuna is said to be on a crocodile, the river. She is said to be on a crocodile. That is.
Okay.
So you see the key points here that I would like to take is a high moral ground. So these people like to take a high moral ground. Even they try to push it as much as possible. Now they could be, they're trendsetters, they're adventurous, very, very adventurous. As I told you earlier, before coming to a balanced state, you know, they will always be very adventurous. You've seen the guts of a guy going and kicking somebody and saying that you're an imposter. So they, as one of my students always tells me, that they have a point of saying, this is not fair, that is not fair, this is not right, that is not right. So they have the ability to judge things. And if the planet sitting there is very free of afflictions, their power of judgment is phenomenal. Okay, so they like to be, you know, be able to just do things absolutely. They will have very clear-cut powers of observation and judgment. And they are legendary. They can become very strong powers in their own field of doing demarcation a lot of times. And these people can appear to be very calm on the outside, but they have a very strong nervous energy. This is my observation. This is my personal observation, that these people give a very cool look on the outside. It feels that they're, you know, they have a great sense of humor. They they are the happening people, but internally there's a nervous energy which is very much working for them in their part.
In fact, you said something about mother and child before.
Yes.
So I just remember when I was talking to this person about whom I was telling, he told me that, you know, one day one lady called him and said, you know, some random lady, this is a different lady. She called him and said, you know, I want a child from you. Like, who are you? I don't know who you are. I'm not seeing you. I'm married, you know. You're like, my God.
His moon is definitely afflicted. Ask him to go and do some remedy for his moon. Seriously.
He wants to do something.
Yeah, to worship some goddess, some devi. For sure. Because the moon shows strong affliction for him. Okay. So we have restraint. Okay, legendary in whatever they do. So I'll take the case of Franz Karl Archer.
Regarding restraint that you said, what I feel is like if the chart is good, then they can restrain themselves. Like in case
That is why the balanced view of one of the criteria, you know, the nakshatras is balanced. It's a balanced nakshatra. So you're balanced when this nakshatra is balanced, only when there is no affliction on this chart. On this nakshatra. Moon, for people, moon is definitely not a balanced planet. Moon is one of the planets, apart from the lagna, moon is the one that is totally high tide, low tide, from Amavasya to Purnima and Purnima to Amavasya again, waxing, waning. So it's not a very balanced planet. So people having moon and Bharani, you need to exert that balance as a free will factor.
Yes, it will not happen automatically.
Yeah, it is definitely. Automatically, they will be swinging. They will be highly imbalanced. They will be. So, if you really. Until and unless you have Jupiter aspecting that.
Yeah, and opposite of this, Swati Nakshatra is there. You know, and Swati is wavering always. So,
they exactly.
might have a tendency to behave like that.
Yeah. So, this gets me to one point of mine, Bhavajit. I have observed, okay. So, any nakshatra, it's not full two padas of Swati, if you see. Four padas of Swati. It's two padas of, first two padas of Bharani with the last two padas of Swati that are matching here. Okay. So, if you see people, especially with, in the first two padas of, you know, Bharani, born, these people will have a more mind which is wavering. In place of the people who are born in the second two padas, then they will have a Jupiter kind of a relationship, Venus and Jupiter relationship. So they are more wise. So if I have been working on the padas in this manner, and I've seen that they make a lot of difference to your, not just lagna or thought process of the kind of person. And opposites will resonate. There will be qualities of opposite resonance. I remember, I don't know whether I told this to you here or in one of my classes, but two padas of this nakshatra, Uttara Ashadha nakshatra, have Pushya nakshatra in the opposite. Two padas. And Pushya is said to be one legendary nakshatra. Similarly, Uttara Ashadha is one legendary nakshatra. See, I'm going off track, but I'm just telling this to you that Uttara Ashadha is another legendary nakshatra. They say is the power of the universe is in that nakshatra because it is ruled by the Vishwadevatas, the combined super natural powers. And Pushya is the guru of the Devatas. So these two, but they also have one point in common. Marriage for this nakshatra people is very, very difficult. Why? Pushya has its point about Brihaspati and Tara and Soma. But Uttara Ashadha nakshatra, the animal is male goose. And it has absolutely no female counterpart in any of the 27 nakshatras. So marriage, for different reasons, is not a very successful thing for these people. The many points we can come across, you know, the many points we can see. Okay. We can see here. Now, we're talking about high moral grounds. So, we see that this person, Franz Karl Archard, he wanted, in those days, there was the, you know, this thing, sugar, which was a commodity only for the very rich. So, he wanted to get it across to the, to every other person, the common man. And for that, he went through a lot of process. He did a lot of work. And you know what? There was an entire contingent of the merchant base, merchant class, and other officials who did not want his products to become a common man's property. So there was time when he was asked not to do that. He was said that they would pay him not to do that. And he was asked not to make his research public and things like that. And you know what they did? His labs were burnt many a times, research labs, and he died penniless. So that is holding the high moral ground. But it is said that later on his grandson went ahead and did what he set out to do. So we'll move on to another story here. I think Yama and Yami, we can skip that story, or would you want me to do that story also? Yama and Savitri.
Yeah, we can do, say in short, I think.
So, Savitri ends up marrying one of the most handsomest. Savitri is a queen, is a daughter of a king, the only daughter of a king, and ends up marrying one of the most handsome men in the kingdom, Albert. He's the son of a king who has been blinded and driven off from his kingdom and now lives in penury. And he lives the life of a sadhu or the hermit. And so the prince, young boy, is actually a prince, but he lives as a hermit with his parents. So Savitri has fallen in love and has to take him up as her husband. So when she approaches her father is equally powerful. And then Narad Rishi comes in and says that Savitri, though you love him, I would not ask you to get married to that man. Okay. So I did not ask you to get married to Satyavan, that young strapping prince who now lives as a hermit, because he's going to die in a year's time. So what Savitri does is she says that I would rather live with my love. She says that I'd rather live with my love for 1 year rather than spending a lifetime with a person I don't love. So she starts living with him. They're very happy. Now, as the day of death is approaching, Satyavan starts growing more and more handsome. Whereas Savitri, because she's aware of the fact, she starts becoming more and more dull. Why? Because the fear shows its presence in her physique. She loses weight, she's worried, everything. Now on the day of his death, he says, I will go into the forest to get wood. And she says, I'll accompany you today. So she accompanies him. Just under a tree when they come, he says, I'm feeling a little weak. I just take a rest. And she realizes that he is going to die. So she says, okay, rest on my lap. And she can understand that he is ebbing away, and she sees Yamraj. Because Satyavan was a prince born with good karma, and he lived a very pious life. So it was not the Yamduts. Yamduts means the messenger. Dut means messenger. It was not the Yamdut. It was not the messenger of Yam coming to get the soul of Satyavan. But Yamraj himself came. So Yamraj said that Savitri, because being a very pious lady, is able to gauge the presence of the celestial being. And as Yamraj is taking the soul away, Savitri first cries, pleads, but Yamraj is unbiased. he cannot be. Death and time, okay, they are brothers. Kal, it's a name, both share a common name, Kal, time and death, okay, and they're brothers, Saturn and Yamraj. So they do not have any bearing towards anybody. In the sense, time does not play favorites with anybody, and neither does death. Today, if I have a good time, I should be thankful. And if tomorrow I have a bad time, I should wait for the good time to come again. Because time is constantly changing. As has been your karma, so will be the results. And similarly, death is something that everybody has to embrace. But he was very young. He was extremely young, Satyavan, and very had a good life in him. So, but Yama is not cajoled. Yama keeps telling her that go back. She moves still with her because she has been a very, very dedicated wife. And so she's gathered that much of penance that she moves still weatherly. And then Yamraj realizes that she's traveled a distance with me. So I have made a relationship with her. And I cannot let her go like that. And she has the power to cross the weatherly. She can give up her life, which she's not allowed to at this moment. So he says, ask for 3 boons and go. So she says that first boon is, may my father-in-law's eyesight and kingdom be restored. Yamraj says, tathastu. And then she says that may my father have a son. So because her father never had a son, she was the only child of her father. So my father have 100 sons, I believe she said. So Yamraj said, tathastu. Then finally she says, in a very, very low-keyed voice, may I also have 100 sons. So Yamraj is in a hurry to go. So Yamraj says, tathastu. That means, so be it. And then she's laughing. And Yamraj says, why are you not returning? So she says, how can I return alone from here? So Yamraj says, what do you mean? So she says that you have given me a boon of 100 sons. But how can I have 100 sons without my husband? So Yamraj says, you have been a very, very faithful wife and a very diligent woman. So I give you a blessing that may you have a long life, both of you, and may you have a very known life. So see, eons after what has happened, Savitri is still today remembered as one of the most pious of women on this planet. Okay, and so she goes back and she sees that her husband is coming out, and then her father has sons and her father-in-law's eyesight and kingdom is restored. And obviously she also has her 100 sons. So 100 sons in those days was possible because they lived for thousands of years. Okay, we're not talking in a time where we live for 60 years, we cannot have 100 children. But it was possible in those days. So death and life is detached. Death has no attachment to anybody. They say, just, you know, I'll put in a key point here, that when time is running good for us, we look upon ourselves with a lot of pride and we look down upon others. We really shouldn't be doing that, because time, as I said, has no attachments. Time and life has no attachments. Sometimes something may happen that everything simply drops. Then you have to start from scratch, back again. So that is what Yamraj is all about. You know, detached, punctual, on time. Absolutely on time. So if we have to meet our maker today at 5 o'clock, maker will make sure that I am on his door at 5 o'clock. So this is about, you know, one scientist who was the father of the modern day X-ray, you know, association. And today we know X-ray today, it's like something that we cannot live without. X-rays are things that we cannot absolutely live without today, in today's day and world. So he was associate. Again, you have Saturn and Moon in Bharani. So if you look at the degree of Saturn, again, it's 19 degrees. You will know that debilitated Saturn in Bharani. It's 1920 degrees. Need not be, you know, stamped as bad, bad, bad. Depend on, again, I keep telling this in most of my classes and most of my videos, that depends on how you are resonating. If you're putting in hard work, this Saturn will definitely, at one point, the planets will have to change. And Saturn is the eighth lord of discoveries. Moon is the Lagna lord. Venus, the dispositor, has gone in the fifth house of gains. And it's with Ketu. The Nakshatra lord has gone in the 11th house, own house of gains. And it's with Ketu. So the gains will be very much directed, very focused and very pure. The person will not be making gains unnecessarily or not be, making fraudulent gains. And it's also the fourth lord of masses. So he did something with his education and masses. He was able to bear results. But you see, Ketu is also about being very spiritual. So he was also imprisoned by the Nazis. Why? Because he was helping the Jews. Okay. So there are many cases that you can see, and Yama and Markande, but then I'll move on to suddenness. Bharani is a planet of suddenness, and he has the ability to bestow. One thing I'll take you across is Bharani and Nachiketa. Okay, and sorry, Yama and Nachiketa, I also like to voice on suddenness. As I said, Yama, Bharani, Venus is resurrection. Okay, and it is a fitting to this nakshatra because we will see that the yoni is the symbol. Okay, and I'll move into detail with this later. And then I will also be taking off, or if it's all right for everybody to remember, Hippolyte Bolt is the, he is the one. We have obstetricians who use certain scissors for labors, difficult labors. They are called Bolt scissors. Okay, and he's the inventor of that Bolt scissor. And what do you see? You see the Lagna Lord, Venus sitting in the 12th house. 12th house is hospitals, but 6th house is also, 12th house is also your surgeries. 8th, 12th, it has relationship with the 6th house of medicine. Sitting in the 12th house, Venus is also the Sinjivani Vidya. Venus is also the resurrection powers. And in the 12th house, Venus is very happy. It gives him international fame. Venus and Saturn together gives you long-lasting fame even after you're dead. So it gave him that. See, again, Saturn is debilitated. Saturn is the 10th and the 9th and the 10th lord. 10th lord of profession and 9th lord of luck. So debilitated Saturn need not be that bad. I will have to say that because it gives you an ability to work hard. And once you start working really hard, because Saturn is also Kal, it will give you one that is due to you. Okay. So Babaji, do you need to say anything here? You want to say anything here?
Very nice.